this evening, so you might want to have access to it, but you won't necessarily need it. So we're recording now. There's a bit of a Good Friday theme to this evening's Imagine. On Good Friday, Christians contemplate Jesus suffering on the cross. They don't do it because it's enjoyable, but they do it because of love. St. Ignatius in the Spiritual Exercises also recommends we do this, that we stand alongside the women at the foot of the cross and just be with him. We're powerless to stop his suffering, but we're present to it. Perhaps we're trusting that God is still there, and that the only way to Easter is through this. In Matthew's Gospel, chapter 25, we've got the parable of the sheep and the goats. And it's where Jesus says, "Whatever you did for the least of my brethren, you did to me." And in the Acts of the Apostles, Saul, who has been flushing out the early Christians and putting them to death, experiences, hears Jesus saying to him, "Why are you persecuting me?" So in both of those examples, we see Jesus identifying with those who suffer. So if all who suffer are, in a sense, Christ, if Christ is all who suffer, are we not at the foot of the cross whenever we are present to suffering? Whether it's suffering of other human beings or of any part of creation. This is a painful place to be. However, love and trust and hope can take us there and help us to stay there. This week's imaginative exercise invites us to contemplate the passion of Christ in the suffering of the planet. I'm not going to leave you there. The cross is not the end of the story, but the way through which we meet the risen, still wounded Christ. So after spending some time in this contemplation of passion in the world, we'll touch upon the resurrection hope already at play in the world. As I say, I'll use quite a few images this evening, which may be helpful. However, you may choose to work with your own images, just what comes into your imagination as I describe a scene. Or you might use a bit of both. I'll also be playing some music quietly as we go, and I hope that's not distracting. So you might want to make yourselves comfortable on your seat. And just notice the space that you're in. And the body that you're in, and how it is this evening. And as you sit here this evening, or whatever time of day it is with you, to let the God who loves you look at you or be with you in any way that God wants. And consider how this God who loves you is the maker of the entire universe. And that you are made of the same stuff as the stars. And the God who is in and who loves all of creation loves this part of creation in particular. As you either look at this image or imagine yourself the image of the earth, let God look at the earth with you. Or rather, let yourself imagine the truth of God's looking at the earth. Over whose waters God's Spirit hovered. And we allow ourselves to be affected by an image of how we have sometimes mistreated the earth. And it may be an image you have in your own memory. Notice what's happening in you. As you contemplate the pollution, the exploitation of the earth. And consider how non-human living creatures are sometimes affected by our misuse. How does God look at this? Because of how we have mistreated the earth, human beings also suffer, and especially the poor. Is there an image of human suffering that comes to your mind? When you gave water to the thirsty, you gave it to me. And contemplate the cross of Christ. I thirst. What do you want to say to Christ? What is Christ wanting to say or communicate to you? Notice where you are, how you are. And again, how God is looking at you or with you. Without trying to force a mood change. Consider or imagine the experience of Mary Magdalene on that first Easter morning. And see on screen or in imagination an example of good being done, of the earth being cared for. Where is God in this scene? and see an image of an individual making a difference. Who comes to mind for you as someone who is doing their bit? And what is the bit that you do to care for this earth and its people? What is Christ's invitation to you? And see an image of a community doing their bit, planting seeds, planting trees. What is your desire for these acts of goodness, seeds and saplings that are planted? What do you want? What does God want? What does the risen, wounded Christ want you to know? Trinitarian God, wondrous community of infinite love, teach us to contemplate you in the beauty of the universe. For all things speak of you. Awaken our praise and thankfulness for every being that you have made. Give us the grace to feel profoundly joined to everything that is. Just return for a moment to whichever of this evening's images is staying with you the most. And be with it, and let God be with you. And we return into the shared space. In a little while, Emma will open the breakout rooms again. And the invitation is, as usual, to share something of where you went